Today I'm going to take you on a tour of my 2006 MINI John Cooper Works. But before we can begin this tour, I need to explain how this car came to be. And I mean this exact car. Let's take a quick look back. No, not that far back. Let's start in 1994. BMW had acquired the Rover Group, and at that time there were already plans in the works to replace the outdated MINI. By 1995, a design emerged that would be selected as the future of the brand. It came from the hands of Frank Stephenson. Stephenson is known for some amazing designs, including the Ford Escort RS Cosworth, the first BMW X5, the Ferrari F430, and a long list of McLaren models. The design evolved, and by 1999 it was finalized. In late 2000, shortly after the last classic MINI rolled off the line, the new modern MINI went into production under the ownership of BMW. This new MINI gave a nod to the past while delivering modern design and engineering. With the wheels pushed to the four corners, it also brought great handling. Soon after, the Cooper S model followed. With its signature hood scoop, the S added a supercharger, and with it came a significant bump in horsepower to around 170. It was around this time that Mike Cooper, son of legendary race builder John Cooper, began to develop performance parts for the modern MINI under his new company named John Cooper Works. John Cooper Works Tuning Kits, or JCW as they became known, added a revised cylinder head, supercharger, and exhaust, producing a significant increase in horsepower.
Hello, my name is Michael Cooper, and I'm the chairman of John Cooper Works. And this is the new 210 horsepower MINI Cooper S.
The product line quickly expanded to include both performance and cosmetic upgrades. Owners of new MINIs could take delivery of their JCWs direct from the John Cooper Works shop or bring their new MINIs in to be retrofitted. Performance parts included larger brakes, suspensions, and a range of accessories. MINI dealerships soon began marketing and installing JCW products too. You can see the catalogs from this time period were full of go-fast parts for owners to customize their MINIs. In 2006, MINI began offering the first factory-built JCW cars. The package cost $6,300, which was nearly one-third the price of the Cooper S. For that price, buyers got the full tuning kit, the brake kit, a mechanical limited slip differential, and the sport package included. By the end of 2006, MINI announced the purchase of the JCW brand from the Cooper family. Throughout the year, MINI engaged in a marketing effort to promote awareness of the JCW brand name. And that's what brings us here today with this exact car. MINI began bringing heavily optioned JCW cars to auto shows. This convertible is one example. And in December 2006, right at the very end of production of the R53, MINI built this exact car for the San Diego International Auto Show. Here's a photo of the cars that originally appeared at the show. In early 2012, I first saw this car listed for sale at MINI of Escondido in San Diego. After seeing what it was, I picked up the phone to place a deposit and buy the car sight unseen. I got in touch with the salesperson only to learn that someone beat me to it the day before. The buyer was planning to fly in from Utah and drive the car back home. A week later, I called the dealership just to check and confirmed that the car had already been driven home by the new owner. Fast forward a year or so to the fall of 2013. I was randomly doing a car search one day, and there it was, the exact same car, listed for sale, this time in Utah. I immediately called the owner and we closed the deal right there. 2 weeks later, the car was delivered and in my garage. It looked a little different at that time with larger 18-inch JCW wheels. I decided to add a few more items to make the car identical to the car shown in the JCW catalog. It stayed this way for a few years when I decided it was time for a change. I bought a brand new set of MINI BBS R90 wheels and made a few changes to style the car similar to the red MINI from the 2003 Italian Job movie. Truly a classic look. So now we can begin the tour as the car sits today. As I mentioned, it's a 2006 factory MINI John Cooper Works car built in the final weeks of production. 2006 was the only year you could purchase a factory-built supercharged JCW hardtop. Later generations switched to the turbocharged motors. This color is chili red with a white roof. The exterior has an Aero kit, as you can see, along with driving lights. It's also a slick top, meaning there's no sunroof. The car also has a JCW Sport suspension installed and these center caps as a finishing touch. On the interior is a matching chili red dash, chrome line interior trim around the gauges and vents, English leather seats, JCW checkered floor mats, an oil temp gauge, and an original boost gauge. Also found is a carbon fiber JCW shifter and a carbon fiber brake handle. The car has the upgraded Harmon Kardon stereo and an Anthracite Headliner. So that is the story of this 2006 MINI. When I bought the car, it had just over 20,000 miles. As of today, early 2021, it has nearly 32,000 miles. Well, that may not sound like a lot. I have taken this car on plenty of regular drives and longer trips from all around the Mid-Atlantic region to Watkins Glen International Raceway in New York to Mount Washington in New Hampshire. We've had plenty of adventures and made new friends along the way. Following from those early days as a show car, there have been a few moments of notoriety. This car was selected to be part of MINI's 50th anniversary display at the Simeone Museum, and it's been featured on several social media pages too. And finally, that brings us to today. It's time again for a change. I made the decision that after 8 years, it's time to find a new owner for this car. This car is about to take the next step in the journey and is soon going back to California where it all began. I'll be handing over the keys to a new owner next week. It's bittersweet letting this car go, but I know the new owner will take great care of it and I've got more plans coming very soon.